Hey, this is Mike. Checking out the bar scene a little bit here in Hong Kong. You're watching Azn Lifestyles TV.
Inside this Vancouver shop is a sound of art being created. Meet Jeff Tam of Monkey King Tattoos.
Good thing you've been working out.
The shop has been open for 3 years now, but he's been tattooing art pieces for the past 11, creating his first piece on himself.
My first tattoo was on my own thighs.
Yeah.
I was tattooing a three-headed alien on my thigh, practicing coloring, lining, and shading at the same time. I went to play basketball, and my friend saw my tattoo on my shorts, and he said, "Hey, do me a barbed wire." And I was like, "All right, let's do it." So I started doing a tattoo on him, and it was supposed to be a barbed wire, but it just ended up being a barb, right? Because of his pain, so that time I almost gave up.
Jeff thinks his talents are genetic, having grown up with a father who's a
traditional watercolor landscape artist.
It's really specific.
Yeah,
just right in
the Mr. Tam.
And what did his parents think about this taboo profession?
Oh, Asian parents in the beginning are always skeptical, right? Hey, how come your son all has tattoos? And you know, why are you, when you're putting ink onto skin, like, is it gonna damage you or something like that? So they're always worried about that, so, but I was able to convince them somehow.
Falling in love with his art of tattooing earlier on in his life, Jeff decided after university that he was going to travel the world to learn from the best and craft his art.
It was freedom from then on, so I decided to take off to Miami and, you know, learn from some people down there. And I learned from one of the best tattoo shops over there, Tattoos by Lou. And from then I met a lot of people and went to Japan, got tattooed there, learned from good masters. Then I went to Czech Republic and I met a whole bunch of artists from Europe. And from then on I just got inspired and decided to come back to Vancouver and put it all together. The style that I specialize in is mostly Asian style influence, such as stuff from landscape paintings, traditional feng shui style stuff where you know, certain animals go with the person's feng shui. The reason that is because, I guess traditionally, I was brought that way. I see a lot of the images from when I was a baby to like right now. I try to do the best that I can do with what I know best.
And the most common tattoo he does?
Koi fish. Why? Because maybe everybody should get a koi fish just for good luck. And even if it's your first tattoo, it seems like everybody likes to have that peaceful little fish. You can change it into more aggressive or happy one. Somebody should have a fish, you know?
But there are tattoos Jeff would like to stay away from.
I would not tattoo anything that would go against your feng shui, meaning that your animal that is not compatible with you. I wouldn't tattoo that because then I just don't want to be held responsible for causing that whatever bad luck it is that would happen. So I would stay away from the non-compatible animals and girlfriends' names. And boyfriend's names, whatever.
Having met many tattooists from around the world during his travels, Jeff has one special person that he keeps in mind when working.
Horiyoshi III is my mentor. I inspired him. He's my idol. I was not taught by him, but I watch everything. I buy his books, and I went to get tattooed by him. I got my whole bodysuit by him, and during that time, I was able to watch and observe what he does and how he starts his tattoo. And you know, he's the style that I follow. I got my turtle here, and the turtle is my mother that represents that one, and this is that's me.
So if you ever thought about getting a tattoo piece but not sure why, Jeff has the answer written all over his body.
I think tattoos definitely is a spiritual thing where you see it more than most things. So when you see it and you believe it, then it will come true.